I'm Donald Osborne, and welcome to another look backstage at the Audrain Automobile Museum. Today, we are giving a preview of our upcoming exhibition, From the Racetrack to the Opera, Marks That Did It All. And one of the surprising marks that are in this exhibition is Duesenberg. Now, you might say, well, the opera, that's for sure, and the racetrack? Well, not many people know that Fred and Augie Duesenberg were first and foremost racers. They built incredibly capable and sophisticated race cars back in the 19-teens and the 20s. Their cars dominated Indianapolis and the 500, winning in 1922, 24, 25, and 27. You would think that with this kind of a great racing heritage and with their brilliant design, they could build a car that would be an absolute world beater. Well, you would think, win on Sunday, sell on Monday. And they tried to, but much like their counterparts in Italy, the Maserati brothers, their brilliance in the engineering shop and on the racetrack didn't translate into business acumen to be able to build a car for the public. In fact, they did introduce a car in 1920, the Model A. And surprisingly, rather than producing a sports car, which would be perfectly natural for people who built winning race cars, they built a luxury sedan, a very sophisticated luxury sedan that was powerful and very fast. But the kindest you can be about the Duesenberg Model A is that most of the coachwork fitted to the Model A was handsome at best, certainly not dashing. They couldn't sell very many of the cars and quickly found themselves in great financial trouble. They sold their name to a businessman who again attempted to reorganize the company and to make it a going concern, but that didn't last very long until E.L. Cord came along. He was the great industrialist building his vision of a great automotive empire with a number of brands, and he saw Duesenberg at the top of that heap. Thanks to E.L. Cord's money, Fred went to work for him and led the charge in creating the great Duesenberg Model J. Here we have a 1930 Duesenberg Model J town sedan with a body by Murphy of Pasadena. This particular Duesenberg has a very special place here in the Audrain collections because of its Newport connection. This car was delivered new and ordered by Nanaline Holt Inman Duke, the mother of Doris Duke. And of course, Nanaline was a woman of great taste. She loved elegant, very, very traditional things. And this Duesenberg, with this elegant Murphy body, is a perfect expression of Nanaline Duke's taste and style. If you look at the typical elegant Murphy details, the very thin A-pillars at the windshield, and the lowered roof line, so that this car, although a formal car, has a very racy look. And of course, this suits the Duesenberg. This car is a 265 horsepower, 114 mile per hour wonder, even with this very formal coachwork on it. It's no wonder that these cars are very popular in tours, where they can really handle the road quite well. And they betray their racing heritage in every movement. Now, another element in our exhibition coming up, Racetrack to the Opera, is the racetrack part. This wonderful car will be paired with a very special car called the Fred Frame Special from the Miles Collier Collection at the Revs Institute. We'll tell the story about that car later, but just know that this is a car that came in second in the Indianapolis 500 in 1930 and then went on after a rebody in 1933 to win countless races in sprint car races across the United States after the Indy formula had changed. Fred and Augie Duesenberg's vision of sophisticated, powerful cars worked whether on the racetrack or driving to the opera. If you like these videos, let your friends know. Subscribe, comment, share.